friends, welcome to our channel Gyan Shree Education Tutorial. Now we'll proceed the next name reaction, that is the Stork Enamine reaction. In this reaction, we will study the reaction of the carbonyl groups, that is the cyclic ketones, with the secondary amine, and the formation of the enamine will take place. Here the reaction is, this cyclohexanone will react with the secondary amine. The formation of enamine will take place. Okay, here what we require is the acidic condition. We usually take PTSA, that is paratoluene sulfonic acid. What the PTSA will do, it will donate its hydrogen, hydronium ion. Now under acidic conditions, what will happen? This is a ketone and H positive. This oxygen atom has its lone pair, therefore it will donate to the proton, and what will happen? This will form. As here we see, the positive charge is on the oxygen, which is more electronegative. Thus it will abstract the electron density more from the carbon atom and making it more electrophilic. Here the carbon atom is present and it is attracting the electron density towards it. Therefore, the nitrogen here, which is present here, has lone pair. Now this lone pair will attack at the electrophilic center, and thus we will get here the attack will happen and this bond will shift there, therefore resulting in the formation of OH and H. Here we can see nitrogen has 4 bonds, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Therefore, it will acquire a positive charge. And we also know that this PTSA is also present as a conjugate base, because it has already donated its proton. Therefore, it will abstract the proton which is present here, resulting in now here nitrogen also has its lone pair, therefore attack will happen. This lone pair will attack here and the OH will remove. Therefore this species is formed. Now here we have two options, that is here we have two hydrogens, also we have two hydrogens here. Now one of the bond will migrate, this bond will shift here and it will go there. Thus is known as enamine. As the double bond represent the ene and it is a amine. Now it is a reacting species. It has activated the compound because here the primary material that we have is cyclohexanone, which is quite unreactive. But after the reaction with the amine, it becomes reactive. Now we will study the further reaction, how it will work. Now this enamine reacts with alpha beta unsaturated compound, that is C double bond O CH3. Now look at the bond movement. Here the nitrogen lone pair will come here. This bond will attack at this position. This bond will migrate here and this from here. So now what we get? double bond and positive charge, because four bonds are made of here, that is CH2, CH, double bond C, O negative and CH3. Now this negative charge will again come here, returning to its position, and this double bond will get here and it will abstract as positive from the solvent. So what we get? Double bond and positive charge, CH2, CH, C, CH2, double bond O, CH3. On further hydrolysis, this group will replace by the oxygen. Double bond O, CH2, CH2, C double bond O, CH3. This is our final product. Therefore, this reaction is helpful for the making the more derivatives, or we can say the more chain lengthening of the compound. This is our final result. The next name reaction is Birch reduction. Birch reduction, basically what we study is benzene and its derivative reacts with sodium in liquid ammonia, taking alcohol as a solvent, form 1,4 cyclohexadiene as a product. Here we take sodium in liquid ammonia. What are the properties of it? First of all, we have ammoniated electrons. The solution is blue in color. As the free electrons are present in the solution, therefore the solution is paramagnetic. Now we will study the mechanism of the Birch reduction. Case 1. Mechanism. Case 1, reaction with benzene. One electron, sodium with liquid ammonia, one electron adds here. What we get? This electron we can represent is a dot, and here the negative charge. Here what we see, there is a great repulsion between this radical and the negative charge. So they will tend to arrange themselves in such a manner to reduce the electronic repulsions. Therefore, this negative charge will come here and this bond will come here. We get there is a radical, here hydrogen is already present. And this negative charge will come here. A double bond is formed here, and the negative charge is placed here. Now, if we take proton H positive from the solvent, therefore, what we get is radical. Now one more electron will come from the sodium in liquid ammonia. that is 1 electrode, sodium, liquid ammonia, we get a negative charge here. Now from also from the solvent, the proton is subtracted and thus resulting in the formation of 1,4-cyclodiene and this is our required product. Now here we will study the two cases, that is when benzene is attached to a group or whether the groups which is attached to the benzene is electron donating and electron withdrawing and how does it affect on the reduction. Case 1. When an electron donating group is attached, we will study the case of toluene. Now here it will take up one electron from the sodium and liquid ammonia and now what will happen, we have two sides of the attack, that is from this side or from this side. As here from this point, that is from the blue point, the electron donating group is attached. Therefore, it will increase the electron density at point here. Therefore, it will become difficult for this electron to reach here or attack here. Therefore, this electron will prefer to attack at the red point. Therefore, what the resulting species is? That is, at the red point, the electron will come here. As the electron will come here, this bond will migrate at this point, and hence the species which is formed is CH3. And the negative charge which will highly repel each other, therefore they will tend to lie at the more farthest positions. Therefore this negative charge will migrate here and this bond will shift here and form CH3 bond, this one. And here look at here, this negative charge comes here, already a hydrogen is present and negative charge is here and here our radical is present. Now from the solvent again it abstracts the hydronium ion H positive or proton from the solvent. We get CH3, a radical again, one more electron is captured by this species. Negative charge and hydrogen. And again a proton is subtracted from the solvent, H positive from the solvent. what we get is CH3 H H H H, and here the hydrogenated product is this, and we can see the hydrogen will take place ortho position and meta position, as this position is ortho and this is meta. So from here we can conclude that electron donating group, when is present on the benzene ring, hydrogenation takes place on ortho and meta position. Now we will study the case 2, when electron withdrawing group is present. Here, for example, we have benzoic acid, C double bond O, O H. Here, this group makes the benzene ring more electron deficient. Therefore, when an electron comes, it will attack at this position, which is marked as red circle. The electron from sodium and liquid ammonia will come here, and this bond will shift here. What we get is OH. Here a radical is present here. It is represented by the black dot, and the negative charge is present here and here. Again, there is a highly repulsive area, so they will tend to repel and place at the farthest position from each other. This negative charge will come here and this bond will come here. Therefore, we get C double bond O, OH, a radical which is marked as black dot, double bond, here also a double bond, and here the negative charge will come, and again a proton is taken from the solvent we get a radical is present, C double bond O, OH. And again, one electron is taken from sodium liquid ammonia. Therefore, it will become C double bond O, OH, which is already the group present. And here, the negative charge will come, and H and H. And again, H positive from the solvent. We get this double bond, C double bond O, OH, H, H, and H. Now, what we see here, that the hydrogenation takes place at two positions, that is ipso position and para position. And ipso position is defined as the position at which the functional group is already present. This position is known as ipso position. And this is known as para position. So what we conclude that whenever an electron withdrawing group is present, the hydrogenation takes place at ipso and para position, and when electron donating group is present, the hydrogenation takes place at ortho and meta positions. Thank you, and if you like my channel, please subscribe it and don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Thank you.